majors, but college baseball season.
It counts. Opening day for the FGCU baseball team. As NBC2's Sean Berry explains, the ongoing MLB lockout does have an impact even on college teams.
If you're looking to fill that need for baseball while spring training remains delayed, look no further than the FGCU baseball team, who are set to open their season tonight.
When you lace those shoes up, it's special, man. There's nothing like opening night.
And with the Eagles coming off a regular season conference title in 2019, a division title a year ago, expectations are sky high.
Yeah, I think we have one of the most talented teams since I've been here. We have some high expectations this year, and we're looking forward to getting after it.
Also, not only are the Eagles the best game in town tonight, they're the only game in town, at least until the MLB owners and players agree to end the current lockout. But none of that concerns the Eagles. What does concern them is that in one of the latest rounds of negotiations, the owners floated the idea of cutting the number of minor league players each team can sign, cutting about 900 roster spots across the board. And for a program trying to send players onto the pros, that's not good news.
It's actually hard to comprehend because it's just been a gradual decline of how many kids get to play at the next level.
Players like Eagles star outfielder Brian Ellis.
I just want to keep playing baseball as long as I can.
Now, right now, the plan to cut minor league rosters doesn't look like it's gaining much traction. And for players like Ellis, that's music to his ears.
Doesn't matter about competition or anything, just me versus everyone else kind of mentality.
In Fort Myers, I'm Sean Berry for NBC2.